Through the gates of the University of New Brunswick, you'll find a picturesque university located in the riverside city of Fredericton. A network of brick buildings is the workplace to some of the nation's sharpest minds and keenest students. Boasting an 11,000 student enrollment in 2014, and with 12 faculties operating out of the Fredericton campus alone, UNB has produced a star-studded cast of alumni, from playwrights to politicians, to robotics engineers and prosthetic developers, who are all revolutionizing their respective fields. Like many universities, UNB has a lot to brag about. And also, like other universities, people have been raped and sexually assaulted at UNB.
He went in for a kiss and it kind of just really derailed from there. Like, my main priority was just making sure that I walked away from it. And I was like, you just put yourself another hour out of the way. It takes forever to walk back to campus from here. And he's like, no, it's fine, but can I come up to use your washroom and to get a glass of water? I'm like, okay. He grabbed me by the back of my neck and he pushed me up against the wall. And pretty much like he used the grip on the back of my hair and on the back of my neck to maneuver me however he wanted to make me move. He took my pants off and I just went kind of slack because he was muscle enough that he could do a lot of damage. I went and I had a bath and there was a lot of blood. Then I didn't sleep, I kind of stayed up and I stared outside my window.
So can we just start off by getting you to tell us your name and how to spell it
so you don't mess that up? So I'm Jen Gorham. I'm the program coordinator here at the Sexual Assault Center. The Fredericton Sexual Assault Center is the only sexual assault center in the province of New Brunswick. Our primary focus is our 24-hour support line. And then we do an enormous amount of public education. So working in schools, grade 8, grade 10, grade 7, grade 8, grade 10, grade 12, campus. When we do a lot of presentations on campus. When we think about our sympathetic nervous systems, how they come online when we're confronted with fear, so the fight, flight, or freeze response, we three all could have one of the responses, right? Some people, after trauma, look fine. Yep, thank you, yeah, oh, I need that, and it's just like, just the facts, here's what's going on, here's what I need. Other people just check out. It's like they can't quite comprehend what has happened to them. Other people might be really upset, might be hysterical.
I've been here since 1984 in the English department, and I'm also involved with the Gender and Women's Studies program. It's pretty clear that we're lacking a policy and that we're not the only university in the country to have been a bit remiss about putting something in place. So in terms of the policy situation, it's been an issue that people have not wanted to deal with very directly for a very long time. First of all, there's a lot of stigma attached to it, right? A lot of women don't want to report. It's a very hidden problem. You know, it's got to be a comprehensive policy, right? It's not just thinking of it as a workplace, but as a living environment as well.
And then he started going a little further, which I was okay with at that point. And then I wasn't okay with it. I didn't let it happen, but like, I wasn't like screaming no or anything like that. was in my room. I started saying like, oh, I don't think so, like, not right now, things along those lines. And he just kept asking like if I trusted him. As of right now, I still don't know how I would report it to UNB.
When someone comes forward and they tell you that they've been sexually assaulted, don't just look at them like a victim. They haven't changed from who they are. We're still who we are. We're still your colleagues. We're still your friends. We're still that classmate that irritates the hell out of you, you know? We don't change. It's just something else that adds to our experience. It's just something to keep in consideration. As long as you're treating other people the way that you would aspire to be treated every day, you don't have to be concerned about anything. It's the fact of the matter is, if we just treated other people properly, then maybe sexual assault victims wouldn't break down when they're trying to report. Maybe they wouldn't keep quiet when something bad happens to them.